Metalaxis defect is due to the extra cations occupying the interstitial side. Now, the extra cation will be actually formed by the metal atoms which are leaving their sites and leaving behind the electrons. Now, you just see here the diagram. Here we have got the ionic solid arrangement, right? Now, if the extra metal atom, right, present on the crystal lattice leave its site and occupy the interstitial site, right, and nearby interstitial position there will be electron entrap to just maintain the electrical neutrality. Now this A plus has come from the metal atom which is leaving its site. Extra metal atom which is leaving its site will get A plus here, and the electron is that one that which it has left when it is leaving its lattice site. The electron which will be left will occupy the interstitial site again in the nearby. Now question comes that why the metal atom is going to leave the lattice site of it and release an electron. It will only occur when it is being heated. So due to extra cation occupying the interstitial site, here we'll take the example of zinc oxide. This is generally white in color, but it has been observed that when it has been heated, right, the zinc oxide, the color of it changes to yellow. Now why the color will change to yellow, right? So let us see the equation, what happens here. Zinc oxide, when it is heated, it will give Zn2 positive ion, half oxygen, that is to balance the reaction, and the two electrons will be released. So you can see here that when this compound has been heated, it is giving Zn2 positive, a metal atom which is losing the electron, right? Now this zinc ion which will be formed here will be occupying the interstitial site, and the two electrons which are released, they will be occupying the interstitial site to maintain the electrical neutrality. Now this type of defect is shown by those ionic solid which are going to show the Frenkel defect. Now the compounds, ionic compound which are likely to show Frenkel defect, and in case of where the anionic vacancy is there the ionic compound which are like, because there we are getting the hole in the lattice side and electron was getting entrapped. So in that case, where the ionic compound which are likely to show the Schottky defect will be formed there, and here it is which are likely to show the Frenkel defect. Now due to this defect, when the extra cation is occupying the interstitial site, right, there the consequences, what is going to be the consequences here or the result of it? The first is, since the electrons, free electrons are available, definitely due to availability of free electrons, electrical conductivity is observed, and the electrical conductivity will be less than the semiconductors, so they are going to form n-type semiconductor. They are good conductor, but they are the semiconductors, and which type? The n-type semiconductor, because free electron, the negative ion, that is negative charge body, is responsible for the flow of the current, right? Second will be, since we have got the electron, so they will show the color to the ionic solid, right? Now this color is shown by the electron because they will get excited to the high energy level, and while returning back they will just radiate out or emit out the radiation which they have observed. So here the zinc oxide generally is white in color. It is showing, giving the yellow color. Why? Because of this electron which is being released here and occupying the interstitial site. The next type of non-stereochromatic defect is a metal deficiency defect, where the number of the metal ion will be less with respect to that of the anions. Now let's see here. Metal deficiency defect, it will be caused due to two reasons, right? First one is due to the cationic vacancy or vacancies, now if you see the array of here oppositely charged ion, right, A plus B negative, A plus B negative, from here you can see that one cation has been missing from its side, right? So the cation has been vacancy has been created. Now to maintain the electrical neutrality, what will happen, the nearby cation, it can be either direction, will acquire one extra unit of positive charge to maintain the electrical neutrality, right? So the cationic vacancy, what is there, a cation is missing from its lattice side, and to maintain electrical neutrality, the nearby cation gain higher oxidation number or higher charge. Right, so here it was one cation missing, so the nearby cation will get one unit of positive charge more. Now here we can see the hole is being created here, so here the electrical conductivity will be shown by this type of solids, which show this type of defect because of the formation of the positive hole and thus form the p-type semiconductors. P-type semiconductor due to positive hole. I will discuss this in detail when we are doing the semiconductors. Now the second type is the extra anion occupying interstitial site. Now here again we have got this array. Now here what will happen, the extra anion, right, here it is B negative, it is occupying the interstitial site. So what will happen, just to maintain, again the same thing is to maintain electrical neutrality, the nearby positive charge will gain one unit of extra positive charge depending upon the charge on the anion. Now this type of vacancy, this type of defect caused by it is rare. Why? Because the anion are bigger in size to accommodate the interstitial site. Right, so in the metal deficiency defect, the cation caused by the cationic vacancy and the extra anion occupying the interstitial site, and here the cationic vacancy will get the electrical conductivity increased, and this is the common one, whereas this one is the rare one because here the anionic size will be big enough to fit into the interstitial site. Now here the cationic vacancy, this one you must have heard about, the fool's gold. Now I'm just telling this thing here. Now this is a fool's gold, which is actually ferrous sulfide, FeS. Now what is gold? Gold is known for its metallic luster, right? Ferrous sulfide, FeS. Here it will, in the array of this oppositely charged ion, it will have Fe2 plus and S2 negative, right? but the Fe2 plus here, there will be this positive charge. I'm just showing you here only. So this is Fe2 positive, it is Fe2 positive here, right? And Fe2 positive here. The vacant, the vacancy, this is Fe2 positive. Now, if this Fe2 positive gets removed from here, what will happen here? The Fe2 positive, which will here, will get 1 unit of positive charge increased, and another one also will be there, which will get 1 unit of positive charge. So when one Fe2 positive gets missing from here, at any vacancy, the nearby two Fe2 positive will get 1 unit of positive charge increased, right? So here what is there? That we are getting the Fe3 positive ion in this array along with the Fe2 positive, right? So there will be, we can say, conversion of the Fe2 plus into Fe3 plus. This array will contain both Fe2 plus and Fe3 plus arrangement. As a result, what will happen? There will be the metallic luster which will be shown, right, by this FeS. Now FeS is known as iron pyrites, right? This iron pyrites, known as a fool's gold because of its metallic luster caused due to the cationic vacancy, which leads to the transformation of Fe2 positive to ferrous ion, ferric ion, and ferric ion to Fe2 positive. Now the next type of defect is the impurity defect. In this defect, whenever a solid, ionic solid, right, is mixed with certain impurities, then a vacancy will be created. Now let us take an example that when sodium chloride, right, it is melted down, and the melt now is mixed with strontium chloride, SrCl2, right, and then it is allowed to crystallize. Now what will happen? The two sodium ions vacancy will get vacant, and in place of one vacancy, the strontium ion will be placed and other will remain empty. Now just see through this this example here. Now we have an impurity defect. What is there? That when certain impurity has been mixed with a pure ionic solid, that time this defect occurs. Now NaCl, when it is allowed, its melt is mixed with strontium chloride, SrCl2, and allowed to crystallize. Now how it will go? By cooling. The crystallization will take and allowed to crystallize, that means it will allow the melt to cool down, right? Then what will happen here? The 2Na plus, that is sodium ion, because here NaCl is in excess and strontium chloride has been added. So here impurity is strontium chloride. This is the impurity. So when this NaCl, it is Na plus and Cl negative, where SrCl2 is Sr2 positive plus 2Cl negative. Both are cation, but you can see the difference in the positive charge. Here sodium has got 1 unit of positive charge and strontium has got 2 unit of positive charge. Right, so what happens? That on cooling, there will be two vacant sides of the sodium ion in its crystal, NaCl crystal. Right, in one of the vacant side, Sr2 positive will be placed and one will remain vacant. Right, because to just maintain the electrical neutrality. So to maintain electrical neutrality, two sodium ions are leaving their lattice sites and one Sr2 positive occupies one of the side leaving the other one vacant, right? Another example can be cadmium chloride mixed with AgCO. This may also result in the impurity defect, and due to this impurity defect, the electrical conductivity of the ionic solid increases.